talked to a lot of people who saw that game, and most of them say it was the most thrilling game they've ever seen. Certainly it has to be with a 27-26 show and the team from Hillsdale passing their way downfield only to be stopped by an interception in the end zone on the last play of the game. And you don't find much more excitement than what we saw that day down in St. Petersburg, Florida. By the way, Rush, that team, that 57 team, it was in 1958 that a lot of these same seniors started their play at Pittsburgh State, and that, by the way, was the only losing season that Coach Connie Smith has ever had. But those boys came back strong, and through 1959, 1960, and 1961, they've won 23 of 24 played, so you can see that they've posted a mighty fine record. They had their longest winning streak in their history, 14 straight coming into this ball game, and they're hoping for their second national championship. Kickoff time is here, and with the play-by-play, Rush Evans.
Gary Olson kicks off for Linfield State. It's a high, wobbly kick going down to about the 10-yard line. It is taken there by Dick Colliver for Pittsburgh. He swings back up to the 20 to the 25 and bounces forward to about the 36-yard line where Gary Yates comes in his white-shirted traveling blankers on both sides. In the backfield, Colliver, a handoff on the swing around, goes to Bob Fulton. He breaks into the open at the 40, to the 45, to the 50, down to the 45, 40. He may go all the way. He's at the 20, the 15, the 10, the 5. Touchdown for Pittsburgh.
64-yard run rush by Bob Fulton. That's the first play of the game. A pitch out to Bob. He went Bill Vogren to kick, and holding will be Chuck Sturdivant.
Well, excitement already on the first play from scrimmage. Tremendous excitement. The extra point is blocked beautifully by soft to Linfield State. Val Barnes standing deep as one safety man for Linfield. The bounding kick is taken by Barnes to the 20, 25 to the 30, 35 to the 40. Almost breaks into the secondary and gets away. Gets to the 42 to the 40. Man on the wing on the left. The quarterback is Bill Parrish. Parrish spins, gives in the backfield to Bill Dressel. Dressel swings to the outside, gets up to about the 44-yard line, and he's bounced to the turf on about the 45 by Chuck Sturdivant for Val Barnes for Linfield. A fake, a pitch out goes to the big one for Linfield. He swings around the left side, moves across the 45 up to the midfield stripe and just over into Pittsburgh territory. Playing is Bill Dressel. The quarterback is Parrish. Parrish swings, gives to his halfback. It is Steve Baquin. Baquin cracks over the right side and spins down near the 45-yard line. The quarterback is Parrish. Straight ahead, banging hard, goes Bill Dressel. Dressel smacks down to about the 42-yard line in Pittsburgh territory. Backfield, out to the right, Jeff Durham for Linfield State. A fake and a straight give ahead to Steve Baquin. Baquin is piled up by one, two, three, four red jerseys there at the line of scrimmage. Leading the charge is Harlan Parrish. Look, throws a long pass downfield that's broken up on the 29-yard line. Intended down there to Val Barnes and broken up beautifully by Chuck Sturdivant. Be looking over a little bit, Mike. They love those good defensive halfbacks. There's the punt by Pat Thurston for McMinnville's Linfield team, and it bounces on the 7-yard line and is down at that point where it'll be the Gorilla's ball. It was down there by Neil May. A flanker out to the right, a handoff to Staten. He bangs over his own left guard, picks up maybe 2 yards, not much more. Banging in there to make the tackle, Dick Flood, defensive linebacker, a senior from Portland, Oregon, who came over from his defensive linebacker spot to make the initial contact with the quarterback. Calling the play. Ben gives straight ahead on the dive to his right halfback. That would be Bill Preston, I believe, who's in there now as we put the field glasses on. He spins, fakes, gives to Fulton. Fulton swings around the left side, squirms straight ahead to about the 14-yard line. He picks up short yardage, not near enough for the first down, and he's piled up at that point by the linebacker again. This time it is Yu Yoshida has forced the punt. Staten on his own 2-yard line, gets his boot away. A beautiful spiraling kick back to the 39-yard line where Dave Rohrer takes it for the Wildcats. He gets back to the 45 and a rushing tackle on the 48-yard line and beautifully executed by Tom Spiewak. Parrish fakes, gives a pitch out to his halfback. Dressel tries to swing around the right side, cuts back, and he's belted hard on the 29-yard line. In there to lead the charge is Mike Riley from defensive halfback. And gives the handoff to Bill Dressel. His halfback slants off the right side, belts forward across the 30-yard line, up to about the 32-yard line. Picks up maybe a yard, not much more than that. Big Jerry Archer, along with Barnes as a flanker, split out to the left. Parrish fades the pass, throws, incomplete, up on the 43-yard line. Intended for just fourth down, and a punting situation for the Wildcats from Oregon. Pat Thurston from... You pronounce that, Mike?
Oregon City, I believe.
Oregon City. He's a freshman, incidentally. 165-pounder gets his boot away from the 20-yard line, a high, wobbly kick.
You can look for them to throw a little bit now, Rush.
Let's watch Vogren, the quarterback. He spins, fakes, he tucks it under, gets back to the line of scrimmage, and swings up for maybe a yard gain. Line T formation for the Gorillas. A spin on the inside reverse. Colliver tries to swing back over his own right guard, and he's piled up. Several white jerseys there to meet him. The whole middle of the defensive line, led by... He's there. A flanker out to the left this time. Bob Fulton stood out 6 yards. Vogren, the quarterback. He fades the pass. Look, throws the pass downfield. That's intercepted on the 45-yard line. There it is, picking off. Looks like Dave Rohr it is. He gets back up to the 45. Barnes is on the wing at the left halfback spot. A pitch out goes to the fullback, Steve Beglin. He finds running room around the right side. Swings forward and dances across the 40 down to about the 38-yard line. On the left, Parrish swings out, looks for a man to throw to, does, incomplete down on the 32-yard line, intended down there for Jeff Durham, his right end from... Saves the pass again, it is thrown down to the 30-yard line, this time for Jim Sadness, and it is incomplete. He has information on his own 47-yard line. Let's see if he angles for the sidelines. He is. A high, spiraling kick. They let it bound. Will it get into the end zone? I believe they might have downed it on about the 1 yard line. They did. A tremendous covering play. And we'll get the man's number for you. Get position. They're from the 1 yard line. Vogren gives to Staden. Staden cracks straight ahead up to the 5 yard line. A flanker over to the right is Colliver. The handoff goes to this Staden again. Staden cracks left tackle. No gain this. He's been a good one. Here's a pitch out to Bob Fulton. Fulton swings out to the outside, moves up near the 10-yard line, and it'll be very close for a first and 10. Dick Flood. Vogren hands straight ahead to Dick Colliver. Colliver bangs over his own left guard, picks up short yardage up to about the 12-yard line. Vogren on the pitch out, gives to his halfback. Colliver coming wide. He's to the 10. He's to the 15, to the 20, to the 25. Still running to the 30, and he's finally bounced out of bounds on the 32-yard line. Hugh Yoshida finally ran him down. Dick Colliver running beautifully as he swings around on the right side. He was hit once on about the 20-yard line, pulled away, and finally moved up to the 32-yard line. First down for Pittsburgh. This Willis, they have the ball on their own 32. The handoff goes to Gary Staden. He cuts around his right side, fights his way across the 35 up to about the 38-yard line. On the flip, it comes back to Colliver. Colliver is dumped for a loss. Vogren, on the option play, started to cut. Here's the pitch out to Bill Preston. He's at the 35, and he's really smothered under on the 36-yard line as he tried to swing back to the weak side. As Vogren-Staden gets it away, it is fumbled on the 29-yard line, and it's bounced out of the hands of Dave Rohr. There's a big pileup. Let's see who's got it. On the 31-yard line in Linfield State territory, I believe the Wild out of the hands of the quarterback for Linfield State. He spins on the inside reverse, gives back to Val Barnes, his halfback, who tries to swing into the secondary. He's belted down at about the 34-yard line. So, from the Camellia Bowl in Sacramento, California, your score on the NAIA network is Pittsburgh 6, Linfield State nothing. Val Barnes slid over to the right for Linfield State as we start the second quarter. Parrish hands off in the backfield to Bill Dressel. Dressel cracked over his own right side, picks up a couple of yards. Parrish on the delayed buck gives to his fullback, Steve Beguin, and he is really piled up at the 39-yard line, the whole middle of the Pittsburgh line. Big Jerry Archman from Oregon City drops back in punt formation on his own 25. The pass and center, he gets his kick away. An end-over-end kick goes down to the 34-yard line. It takes the Pittsburgh bounce down to the 20. That first play. A flanker over the left, Dick Colliver. Vogren on the delay, gives to Staden, and he's piled up for a big loss back on the 25-yard line. Vogren fades the pass. Throws a screen pass out to Bill Preston. Preston has the block. He gets to the 30. On his feet to the 35 to the 40. He spins up to the 42-yard line. And he's finally brought down and run out of bounds by Len Tiro over on the 43-yard line. A beautiful screen pass for Pittsburgh. And wait a minute, there's a flag down on the play back on the 30-yard line.
Rush, I'm not sure, but I think they saw an illegal receiver downfield.
on the option, flips it back to Colliver. Colliver is belted hard at the 16-yard line as he tries to swing to the outside. And there to T formation this time. Bogren fakes on the option, may keep, gets to the 25, to the 30, to the 35. He finally bounced to the turf on the 33-yard line. There to make the tackle. There's an injured Linfield State player down on the 32-yard line, so time is momentarily called out by the officials at this point. 6 seconds remaining here in the first half. Pittsburgh still with that 6-0 lead on that electrifying 6. Pittsburgh still has that lead. Here's the boot. A low, spiraling kick goes down to the 30-yard line. It is taken on the 30-yard line by Dave Rohr. Rohr tries to find running room, and he's bounced to the turf on the 41-yard line. There to make it. Still has it. Gives back to his halfback, coming wide. That's Val Barnes. Barnes is dumped on a beautiful defensive play by Archie Ringenberg, the lad we were just talking about. Back. Running laterally, throws a flat pass. Out it goes, complete to Bill Dressel. Dressel fumbles the ball. It's rolling loose at the midfield stripe. And Pittsburgh has it. Looks like Mike Riley. Mike Riley. Bogren on the option. Still has it. He dumps as he crosses the midfield stripe. Gets down to about the 47-yard line. The fake give out to Bob Fulton, trying to get wide. Fulton is dumped at the 45-yard line. There to make the tackle. Bogren fades the pass. Looks, quick pass. It completes beautifully to Bruce Roach. And Roach is dropped immediately on the 30. Fakes to his fullback. Pitch out goes to Colliver. Colliver running wide. Has trouble. Gets across the 30 down to about the 28-yard line. Dave Rohr again from his defensive. Bogren pitches it back to Colliver. Colliver's hit. And he gets away from one man. Swings up across the 30. Spins down to about the 27-yard line. He spins, tries to give on the inside reverse. He's being chased, and he's dropped for a big loss. All the way back on the 2 seconds remaining. Let's see where they're going to mark it. They're going to mark it right. Put out to the right. Handoff goes to Steve Beglin. Beglin finds big running room. Swings around the right side and fights his way up to the 29-yard line for Linfield State. Jerry Archer made the tackle for Pittsburgh State. Helped. Time. Parrish fades the pass. A long pass downfield. It's incomplete. Way down in Pittsburgh territory. Intended for Val Barnes. Barnes. Trying for the one, and Beglin is dumped for a loss. Back on the 27-yard line. Archie Ringenberg, a stalwart defensive play along with Jerry Archer. 14-yard line. A bad pass from center. Can he get his butt away? He does. A wobbly kick going down to the 40-yard line. It's taken there by Bill Preston from Pittsburgh. And he's going to be smothered all the way back on the 35-yard line. Preston couldn't get underway.
They have a good chance to come back next year.
5 minutes to go in the half. Pittsburgh has it on their own 35-yard line. Bogren fakes the throw. Does throw. Incomplete on the 37-yard line. Intended there for Bob Fulton. Fulton was covered nicely. As a flanker out to the right. Bogren is the quarterback. He fades. He may throw. He's going to look. He throws a long pass downfield. It is incomplete down on the 20-yard line. Intended down there for Bob Fulton. And overthrown by about 4 yards. Jack Deans was the defensive halfback back there with Bob Fulton.
Rush, that was the same play that broke the Omaha game wide open. And that long, long pass. Phil took his time against Omaha and pegged to Fulton for a touchdown, which gave the Gorillas a 2-point lead at halftime. The Gorillas...
the left. Bogren calling the play. Spins. Gary Sage smacks straight ahead. Bangs near the 42-yard line. I believe he has that first and 10. A big pileup on the 42.
Paul Schleicher set that in 1959.
He's been a good one. Bogren on first down, fades the pass. Has trouble. And he's dropped for a big loss. Way back on the 49-yard line by Pete Denginnis. Denginnis on beautiful pursuit. A top on second down. Colliver, a flanker on the left wing. Bogren calls the play. Spins, tries to give on the inside reverse, hangs on. Throws a long pass downfield. He has Gosh there. Roach, and it's just out of his reach. Down on the 15-yard line, Bruce Roach looked right up into the sun just as the ball was coming into his reach, and I believe he slowed down just for an instant. Had he stayed underway and sprinted towards the end zone, I believe he might have caught up with that ball.
That was it, Rush. Fruits was going pell-mell down the near sideline. See what they do with a minute and 42 seconds to go.
Bob Fulton on the wing. Fulgren is fading the pass. Looks downfield. Throws. It is complete to Bruce Roach. Up on the 20, the 34-yard line. Formation, Fulgren calling the plays for Pittsburgh State. On the inside reverse, he fakes, he's going to throw. Downfield, he has the man there. It is caught beautifully. Wait a minute, he dropped the ball. I thought for a moment Tom Gosch had it. It looked like to me. Here in the Fulton again, Fulgren fades the pass to the right as Bob Fulton again. Fulgren fades the pass. He's being chased. Runs out to the right, still hangs on, still looks, goes downfield. It's intercepted on the 20-yard line by Dave Rohr for Linfield State. He dashes back up to the 29-yard line, and he stops there immediately. Over to make the tackle is Bruce. Immediately. The handoff goes to Steve Baglin. He finds a big hole. He swings up to the 40, up to the 45, to the 50, to the 45, 40, down to the 35, and he's finally run out of bounds on the 32-yard line in Pittsburgh territory by Gene John, who chased him down from his halfback spot. Steve Baglin. He's running laterally to the right, looking for a receiver. Pass is complete. It's up to Bernie Grant. Grant has run out of bounds on about the 23-yard line. Archie Rinkenberg makes the defensive play for Pittsburgh. With six defenders back. Four receivers go down. Parrish throws a pass down on the 7-yard line. It's incomplete, intended for Val Barnes. Barnes stops the clock now with 8 seconds remaining in the first half. Yard line in Pittsburgh territory. 8 seconds to go. Curry fades the pass. The long pass into the end zone is intercepted by Pittsburgh. Gene John intercepts it in the end zone, and that will end the first half. Beautiful defensive play by Gene John from Burlington, a sophomore, and that ends the first half. I think he just stood in the end zone hoping somebody could go up
sort of
higher.
An alley-oop pass. Sort of an alley-oop pass, right?
Hoping maybe it bounced up in the air and come down.
You know, Rob, it's a real pleasure on behalf of our team to accept this very fine trophy. Thank you very much.
To go. Dressel and Barnes standing on the 10. Here's Bogren's kick, and it's going short. It's down the middle. It'll have to be fielded quickly, and it's fielded finally in there by Yoshida. Yoshida gets back to the 35, and that's all. Chuck Sturdivant, the first. T formation once again. The wing back is Barnes out to the near side. Parrish, the man under. He spins to the right side and gives to Begwin, trying to get to the outside. He's got running room up to the 35 to the 40 and spun out of bounds by Archie Ringenberg at the 41-yard line. Afternoon. Now the play, a fake and then a give to Begwin as he tries the left side, and Merkin's in there along with Bill Beeson and Nip Shepherd to bring him down at the 48-yard line. Check that. Parrish fumbling. He picks it up and he is short of first down. Parrish, as he spun out of the center position, fumbled the ball, picked it up. Here's the snap from center, the kick, and it's almost blocked, but he gets it away, and it's a boomer. It sends Preston all the way back to his own five. He curls up that far sideline, trying to reverse, gets away from one tackler to the 10, and he's formed under at the 11-yard line. Tacklers all over the field. Whitechurch, Gary Yates get out of that pileup. Also, Snaden and Colliver. This time it's Bogren keeping and hitting the 15-yard line where he is rolled under, and it's Tom Buckner leading the charge for the Linfield Wildcats, number 70. Third quarter. Bogren takes, spins out to the right side. He has not pitched. Now he does the full in the same play that went 64 yards for a touchdown. It goes far less than that this time, but it is enough for a first down as Fulton's a straight dive play, and carrying the ball is Fulton as he jackknifes across the 26 to the 28-yard line. Joe Rainwater, a freshman from New York. Right. Bogren starts left. There's a mix-up in the backfield, and Phil adlibs very well, crosses the 30 and gets to the 31. Gary Yates makes the stop, and Neil Main also to throw a shoulder into the Oliver. Third down, four. Bogren takes, pitches back to Fulton, going wide. He's hit from behind, and Tom Buckner downs him at the 31-yard line. At the good pass from center, he gets the kick away. It's a low end-over-end kick, which is fielded by Deans at the 40. Comes to the near sideline. He's being hemmed in and is down at the 46. Making the stop. Takes jump pass over the middle. Then he comes back down. He can't find a receiver. He's tackled at midfield by Gary Merkin, the sophomore from Raytown, coming in to make the stop. Parrish jumps. Barnes is out on the wing left. Parrish pitches the ball to Begwin. He's got three blockers to the near side, the 45 to the 44. Merkin came in to make the stop, number 50. Started use of the hands penalty. Sets the Wildcats back 15 yards from midfield of their own 35 yards. Back to throw. He shoots one in the flat. It's completed out there to Dressel, the running back. He gets away from one tackler. It's blocked off his feet at the 41. And it's Bill Beeson who does the blocking across the way. They need some 17 yards, and Parrish fakes. He's going to throw. It's a wobbly heave. It's intercepted on the near sideline by Chuck Sturdivant, who returns to the 46-yard line. Coffeeville. Bogren sends Tolliver in motion to the near side and gives the signal, and he finds his hole across the 45, getting down to the 41 as a penalty marker drops. Here's a dive play, and they explode Fulton through, and I think he's got a first down at the 35-yard line. Tremendous straight-ahead blocking by Rich. Formations in the Camellia Bowl in Sacramento, California. Tight T formation. As Bogren slides to his right, he keeps and pitches the ball, and he's got a block. He hits the 30 and is inside the 30 to about the 28-yard line. Jack Deems comes up to make the... Here's the dive play, and the handoff goes to the left halfback, Colliver. Flood makes the stop. It's short of first down at about the 20... Snap the handoff. They'll fake it, and Bogren keeps, and it gets first down as he dives across the 25 to the 24-yard line. Fine fake... Image. Here's Bogren pitching to Colliver. He fumbles. He picks it up, and he gets to about the 22. Rush, there was a weird play. The ball was... Back in the screen to Colliver. Colliver gets away from one tackler, gets inside the 32 about the original line of scrimmage before Dick Flood makes the stop once again for Linfield. Boy, there was a man who was jackknifing across the 25, gets to about the 24-yard line. And let's see who makes the stop. It's Neil May, number 33, the senior from Gerhardt. Goal on fourth down, and Bowman's going to throw. Button hook, he throws, it's intercepted, and his pass is intercepted by Ayotte, and Ayotte returns to the 26, and that's all. Side to Dressel. He's in trouble in the backfield. He may be hit. He is going to be hit. A drop for a loss. Shepard and Sturdivant make the stop for Pittsburgh State at the 17. They call it the 18. Here's the snap to the quarterback and again to the second man through, and that's the running back, Dressel, and he gets very... And as we've called it for you, Parrish is back to throw. He's got time. He fires. A man open. It's complete to Durham. He's going to be close to the first down. I believe he did drag the tackler across the 37. And gives the ball to Dressel going wide. He's going to be hit at the line of scrimmage, but falls forward to the 40-yard line. The blocking failed to form as he tried to use it. Here's the reverse coming to Bill Dressel, a fake right, and then it gives Dressel as he counterbucks to the left side. He gets blocking and moves to the 45-yard line before Gary Hatfield, seeing action for the first time this afternoon. The call, and he may have first down. It's going to be very close. He tried to just run... right up the middle, trying to find blocking by Reese, Grossen, and Von Appen. Down, fourth.
Quarter to go, but now, wait a minute, timeout is being called, and the offensive unit is going back in. Maybe they're going to try for it.
He's got the wind at his back, but for only 25 seconds, that won't be a factor in any way. And off going, keeping big fullback, back when he gets first down, across the midfield side, down to the Pittsburgh 45-yard line. He needed a half yard, and he... End of the third quarter with Linfield ball first down on the Pittsburgh 45-yard line. The score, Pittsburgh State 6, Linfield College nothing.
The right, a wide flank to the left is Val Barnes. Wildcats are on the march. The ball on the Pittsburgh 45-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. A flat pass goes out to Barnes. He swings down to the 40, down to the 36-yard. All right, let's see what Parrish has in his bag of tricks this time. He fakes. He's going to throw. He's back. He's being rushed. Long pass downfield is incomplete. Down on the 20-yard line. Timeout called by Linfield State with 14:27 remaining in this game. And your score, Pittsburg. Fakes to his fullback, gives a swing picked out to Baekwin. Baekwin has that first and 10 as he spins down to the 30-yard line. On a pitch out, this time it goes to Dressel, running wide around the right. He has running over the 25, he bounced out of bounds on the 21-yard line. Defensive play there by Gene John for the Pittsburgh State Gorillas. Parts the play, spins, gives to his halfback Dressel. Dressel swings to the outside, being chased by Chuck Sturdivant, and dragged down by Sturdivant right on the line of scrimmage at the 20-yard line. And a great play. He picks it up, gets back to the line of scrimmage, has the first down. As he crosses the 20 down to about the 18-yard line, there to make the defensive stop, starts shooting and burst for Pittsburgh. First down, gives to Yoshida. He crashes over the right side, belts his way down near the 10-yard line, about the 12-yard line. Mike Riley. Second down, about 4 yards to go for a first and 10. The handoff to Dressel. Dressel running on the inside, cuts back, moves near the 5-yard line. Dressel started to cut to the outside, cut back over the middle, and bounced his way down to the 5. Gorillas call timeout. We'll keep it right here for now. Parrish calls the play. Ben gives it to Yoshida. He piled up and dropped for about a yard loss back to the 7-yard. Shot goes to Baekwin running wide. He's at the 8 and he's up for another yard loss. Back to about the 7 or 8 yard line. And the Gorillas look for a man. Goes near the goal line. It's intercepted on the 5-yard line by Archie Ringenberg. He's back to the 25 to the 30. He's going to go all the way. 45-50, 45-40 to the 30. Big chase. He's at the 15 and he's struck on the 7-yard line. With a flag down on the play. Great play, Archie Ringenberg. He gives to Staten. Staten bangs over his own right guard down to about the yard and a half line. Staten again bangs down to the 1 yard line. 3 yard line and it's flagged all over the place. It looks like a very heavy about stop. Staten, he's touchdown. Staten places in over his own right guard for the TD. And Pittsburgh has taken the lead now 12 to nothing. And it is blocked again. And breaking through there, it looks like Neil Main, number 33. Again, the kickoff is fumbled by Yu Yoshida. He picks it up, comes back from the 35 up to the 37-yard line, and he's burrowed under there, led by Harlan Hess defensively for the Pittsburgh Gorillas with Bill Beeson helping out. Now, quickly, 10 seconds to station identification. This is the NAIA Football Network. Yoshida, the fullback. He finds running room. Fights his way all the way down to the 39-yard line. Running beautifully. Hits two, three times. Spins down to the 39, where Archie Ringenberg makes the final tackle for a pitch out. Out it goes to his halfback Dressel, running wide. He gets to the 35, down to the 30. He's hit and dropped on the 27-yard line. A good driving tackle there by halfback Dressel trying to get over the left side. He cuts back, finds some running room inside the 25 to the 24. Perry shakes the pass. Look, goes downfield. It is complete on the 15-yard line to Bernie Grant. And Grant is immediately dropped on about the 16-yard line. There to make the remaining in the game. It's timeout called by the Pittsburgh Gorillas. Your score, Pittsburgh State 12, Linfield State nothing. Goes to the halfback, that's Dressel, running wide. He's at the 15, he's at the 10, and he's pulled down on the 8-yard line. Mike Riley made the tackle for Pittsburgh. And Yoshida is dropped on the 10-yard line as he tries to slant over his own right tackle. And there it is. This time he's fading the pass. Look, he has a man complete on the 6-yard line. He's Bernie Grant. He's in there for a touchdown. Bernie Grant from Hartford, Connecticut, 190-pound junior, took a beautiful 8 seconds to go. It's now 12-6. And this could be a very important extra point coming up. It is good. And now it's timeout as the teams come up the field. And your Sacramento, California. Pittsburgh State 12, Linfield State 7. They get a kick away. It's a little longer than we expected to see. It fumbled momentarily, but picked up finally by Bill Preston. He gets back to the 20, to the 25, and he's hit on a hard driving tackle on the 25-yard line by Neil Main. Bogren gives to Staden. Staden swings over his own right tackle. One, two, three, four white jerseys there to meet him after he picks up about two or three. Right T-formation. Pitch out goes to Fulton. Fulton running wide. He is slowed down as he crosses the 30-yard line up to about the 32-yard line. Dave Rohr, number four, unnecessary roughness.
Piling on too, Rush, I believe that it's full spun wide, a little over eager, certainly not done on purpose, but
down to the left. Bogren gives to Staden. Staden bangs in as he slides in over his own right guard. Picks up maybe a couple of yards down to about the 49. The middle again, carrying tacklers with him over into Linfield territory down to the 47-yard line. And immediately Linfield State calls timeout as Neil Main makes the tackle.
Strictly for blocking purposes. Rush.
The gorillas are out of it. Right. Bogren gives. Gosh, slipped out 4 yards to the right. Bogren gives to, on the option, he gives to Fulton. Fulton dives out to the left side, gets down to about the 46 and a half yard line. The tackle there made by Tony Ayat, a freshman from Honolulu. A minute and 48 seconds to go. There's the boot. It's angling towards the sideline. It's caught on the 10-yard line, and the run back starts with Pat Thurston carrying. He is belted out of bounds by Gary Staden, the right. Gary fades the pass, throws. It's good. Completes the Durham, and he immediately runs out of bounds as Archie Dingenberg makes sure he doesn't go any farther. On. Here, but no, they're going to pass. They figure they can save it down. It's complete on the 40-yard line. Completes the Val Barnes. Barnes is dropped immediately by Chuck Sturdivant for Pittsburgh, and Linfield calls timeout. We'll keep it right here. And they're certainly conserving those precious seconds. We're in the fourth quarter with a minute and 27 seconds to go. Pittsburgh has the lead, 12-7, and Linfield has the ball on their own 37-and-a-half-yard line. Is fading the pass. He's being chased. Look, goes a long pass downfield. He's got a man there. 25-yard line. Jeff Durham had gotten behind Archie Ringenberg with the jump out of his reach. It's Parrish back to pass. He's being chased. Goes a pass downfield. It's almost intercepted. It is over the head of Bernie Grant. It's coming up quickly from the secondary for Pittsburgh. Fades the pass for Linfield State. Goes a short pass downfield. It's incomplete on the 49-yard line. Again intended to Durham. And it was over. Off the clock.
Rush on that play.
Here's the do-or-die play, probably. He's going to go. He has the ball knocked out of his hands. A big pile up on the 35-yard line. Breaking through there was Bruce Roach on a